want to thank God today for the Holy Spirit. And I jumped all over the place this week in the scripture. And it struck me hard what Pastor said one day when he said that sometimes when you're just coming into service or even when you're sitting there, the Holy Spirit will change the script because someone needs to hear something. Or the scripture that you're going to talk about has to support what's already been spoken about. So here we go. So I'm reading from the book of Mark, and I'm going to read chapter 1, 1 through 13. Talking about the Holy Spirit, Old Testament, as when he was only on people for a little bit of time, for one short, like if somebody needed power, he got it for that moment, that task, that journey, and then the Holy Spirit went back to the Trinity. And then how the Holy Spirit came with Jesus, and then how the Holy Spirit lives inside of us as a gift. At the beginning of the facts of the good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. I guess I don't need these. That's new development, sorry. Hold on here. Look at that. I gotta say hallelujah right now.
Hallelujah. Do it to all of us.
Came over my eyes. And, okay, I'll take it. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Father.
This is. Thank you. Just as it is written in the prophet Isaiah, behold, I send my messenger before your face, who will make ready your way. A voice of one crying in the wilderness, shouting in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord, make his beaten track straight, level and passable. John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness or the desert, preaching a baptism, obligating repentance, a change of one's mind for the better, heartily amending one's ways with abhorrence of his past sins, in order to obtain forgiveness of and release from sins. And there kept going out to him continually all the country of Judea and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem. And they were baptized by him in the river Jordan, and as they were confessing their sins. And John wore clothing worn of camel's hair and had a leather girdle around his loins and ate locusts and wild honey. And he preached, saying, after me comes he who is stronger, more powerful, and more valiant than I, the strap of whose sandals I am not worthy or fit to stoop down or unloose. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And when he came up out of the water, at once he, John, saw the heavens torn open, and the Holy Spirit, like a dove, coming down to enter into him. And there came a voice out from within heaven, you are my beloved Son, and you I am well pleased. Immediately, the Holy Spirit, from within, drove him out into the wilderness, into the desert. And Jesus stayed in the wilderness, in the desert, 40 days, being tempted all the while by Satan, and he was with the wild beasts. And the angels ministered to him continually. I think Holy Spirit is just telling me that 40 days in the desert and the angels ministered to him continually. And we have that same grace from God. We have that comfort. We have the angels ministering to us continually. And we have the Holy Spirit living in us once we accept him. Yes. Thankful. And I just got healed.
Oh my God.